My name is Dave Momo. You could say that all the work I do is abstract, you know, looking, and then maybe more than abstract, it's not even abstracted. It's not representing anything, it's non-representational. It's just purely the formal elements of line and shading, color and rhythm, and it's a composition of these things that you can put on a wall. And it's only meant to be those things that are on the wall, so it's kind of meant to be honest in that way. It's not telling you anything you need to believe, it's really just what you see. And in that way, maybe it's like a song without lyrics that you can enjoy kind of with your senses, and you don't have to know the language or be schooled. In the case of art, you know, you don't need like a specialized education to look into what I'm doing, I don't feel. Yeah, there's not much that I'm working with, so color has to be like a big one of those. And my colors at this point are trying to find like a few more odd combinations. I started, the path that I'm on now really started with like primaries and real simple combinations. Because I felt like I was trying to keep everything very honest and straightforward. But now the colors are getting a little tricky, like there's more playful relationships with them. And
then we have granny, ox, coral, berry berry milkshake, and I think that's it.
They'll seem to be very simple colors, but I'll sully a few of them and to adjust how they're all gonna work well together. Yeah, maybe one of the last ones we did right over here, which is just a collection of colored scribbles, strikes me in the biggest way, because I've thought about that mural technique for ages and proposed it, but the proposal looks like nothing. But I knew that if we did it large scale with tape and did it really precisely, that it would have this look which kind of transcends a couple things for me. It looks like handmade shading, or like if you'd use colored pencil, try to like shade something or do it by hand. But then it has a precision to it and saturation that you only get with the paint, and it's large scale. I feel like it's intersection of a lot of things that are really odd, and I'm probably most excited to see that one, even though it doesn't have like the biggest impact. I've been waiting for it the longest.
Probably one of my favorite ones. Yeah, I like it a lot. It's just an experiment, I guess.
Yeah.
It's really nice colors, really clean, really satisfying to see. I really like the blue against the sky.
Yeah.
Well, when I'm doing outdoor paintings on walls, I do keep coming back to a sky blue quite a bit, because that does something that like breaks the architecture when you see sky around it, like joins the, it looks like you've punched a hole through the wall in this way that no other color could quite do that. And it's oftentimes, if you painted a wall, the closest consistent proximity that you have to, you know, color you have to work with. So I referenced, I think, sky blue quite a bit. I like to have the final result be composition that's as simple as possible, so that maybe there's like a labored process, but you can read it and it's legible in a way that it's not full of all kinds of garbled layers that are unnecessary that could not have been edited down and made more concise. So I want the final result to be as pared down and economical, straightforward as possible, so people can read some sense into what's happening. Like, we're not up there making wild decisions because we feel one way in the morning and changing it at night, or it's more to a plan that was whimsical in a moment, but we like stay true to this as simple as possible plan. And that's kind of a key ingredient in all the work that I make, I want it to seem really lighthearted and playful, but I've chosen just like one frame out of hundreds of variations, you know, that I tried, because I thought that one had something interesting that was happening.
Well, we wanted people to be engaged by it, because I think that's the whole point of art, is to have some kind of a engagement or an emotional response to it or an opinion of some sort. And we thought that, you know, the abstract nature of, you know, Momo, I think was a really good fit. And I don't know if Lindsay's probably good with it now, but I think at one point she was like in passing saying, you know, I'd like to eventually have someone like, or do something to the back of the art center. And we took her word. We're like, well, actually,
yeah,
we think it'd be, you know, we have somebody in mind.
Yeah, he was our first choice, and we just messaged him, kind of thinking it was a long shot. Mm-hmm. But he said, yeah, he said he'd love to.
Well, so. We had just bought one of his pieces, too.
Yeah.
So that was sort of our way of like kind of showing that we were definitely appreciating, because we're collectors of his art. Mm. And he responded back.
Yeah. Totally emphatic about it. He was absolutely for it.
I think that the way he saw it, too, was he understood what the art center was to Yuma. And kind of where it sort of was, this sort of transition and kind of, you know, being accessible. So I think he also really liked the unique nature of the building.
Yeah.
I think that was something that he said when he was thinking about the location, because we said, well, we're from Yuma, Arizona. He's like, well, where's that? Because that's where everybody was at. And so I think after doing his research, he realized that the sunlight here is very different than, you know, light and stuff in other parts of the world. And I think that's probably what drew him even more. Which I think is really cool, because it's not until you talk to an outsider do you then start to appreciate other things in your community that you hadn't really, I mean, I knew it was hot, I just didn't realize that the actual sunlight was different. It makes sense.
The landscape in Yuma I find like just amazing. The landscape has all this saturated sun, dramatic skies, like, you know, today we have these insane clouds happening, and just like a kind of scarcity of plant life, you know, it feels really dramatic the way it's, I really love it. I love being outdoors anyway, and observing nature and that kind of thing, so this is a treat for me. I don't get to spend much time in the desert. This is my first trip to Yuma, so I feel like honored to be here and painting in everyone else's space. Everyone's been incredibly nice and generous, but every place I go has a like pre-existing energy that I'm like a guest to be part of, and when I'm gone, the energy's, I've just had like a moment mixing with it, and the energy will still be there, so.
Well, there's a lot of logistics to put together to make a project like this happen. We're in the historic district. We have to go through the Historic Design and Review Commission with the city. We've got the Parks, Arts, and Recreation Commission that have to approve a project like this. Trying to do something contemporary in a historic district was a little ambitious, I would say, in our part, but we were welcomed with open arms every step of the way in terms of getting the renderings approved, the budget approved, figuring out what community partners could come into play to help support it, because it was completely funded by the community itself. No city resources were attached to this, so it was a really great opportunity for everyone from all different walks to come together and make this project possible. So in terms of like the aha moment, or maybe of when we knew it was going to happen, as soon as we got the renderings from the artist of what it could look like on our space, it was just too good to be true to think that this could happen. The rendering looks exactly like what we got.
We had everything in excess to like kind of play around, yet people were still really enthusiastic about what we were proposing, which I think is amazing, and that really surprised me. I didn't think that, I thought at some point I'd hit resistance, you know, with people just saying like, that's a blob. You know, we don't need a blob on our building, to which I would say, well, that's maybe like a valid thought, but we never reached that point. I thought we would.
Having local art is wonderful. That's something that I stand for, and I try to teach a lot of people how to do art, but having an outside source is wonderful. Having an outside eyeball on our little society is a way to help us grow even more. I mean, if we all had the same ideas and the same murals, we wouldn't really grow. This is totally different and something that hasn't happened yet. So I think it's very important that we welcome all types of artists, international or local or whatnot.
Momo Mural is right on. It's vibrant, it's big, it's high impact, and I think that leaves a very positive impression on the community, and hopefully it gets other people excited about more public art and having more murals and more art in Yuma.
When I first heard that Lindsay was bringing in a major artist to do a mural, I was excited. Something new that you could be seen, that could be seen from the backside of Madison, and something more for downtown, I thought it was fantastic. Just one more thing to look at and for people to come and appreciate.
So to see something like this going on, kind of an adaptive reuse and some interesting new development on top of a historic area is fantastic.
I would say it's one more reason to come to Yuma, and it's been a lot of fun.
Oh, I'm amazed. I've been watching the progression from day one, so I've seen all the phases of it, and I'm just in awe of the work. It's just beautiful. I'm always hopeful Yuma's going to continue to grow, continue to be eclectic and diverse in all that it offers. So anything like this, it's a masterpiece, and it's right here in the heart of town, so I'm really happy about it.
I think it's beautiful. I think we should keep it up. I think the arts are wonderful. They bring people into an area, they bring money, and I think we just all benefit. You know, the well-being increases when we have arts in the community.
I think public art specifically has the power to revitalize a community, and I think what we're seeing right now in Yuma is a renaissance happening in community development, not just because of art, but I think art is very visual, it's very instantaneous, you can see it happen in real time, and it's building civic pride, it's building community investment, it's beautifying our community. And I think in the downtown area specifically, we've had three murals plus some of the mini Momo murals go up, would make it about a dozen murals go up in the last 2 years alone. So thinking about that process is really the community investing in itself and building that civic pride, which I think is what differentiates us from other communities, even of similar size or of completely across the country, because art is, it's not a one-hit wonder, but there's no other mural like this in the state of Arizona, let alone in the country. You know, this is completely unique to Yuma, so we can have a lot of civic pride into that, and it's become a selfie station. It's a place to be versus before this, it was just a blank wall in a parking lot, and now like it has an identity to it.
Just thanks to everyone that helped make this happen. It's been really crazy. We proposed the weirdest idea like a year ago, and then everyone stayed on it, and there were meetings. I saw photographs of meetings I couldn't believe, and it all really happened. So that's totally nuts. Thanks to everybody.